Are these people harassing you?
Harassing him? We're his parents!
I told you, Mother. This is for your protection.
Protection? From what, exactly?
He just got back from Delphi. Spoke with the Oracle. Been out of his mind ever since.
She revealed my prophecy. My mind has never been more clear. She said I would do unspeakable things to my parents. That Mother's blood would stain the earth. And Potter would scream to the gods in agony.
Oracles and prophecies do more harm than good. You should listen to your gut. What are you doing?
Listening to my gut. And it's telling me my parents will suffer if you don't help me.
Here we go.
You could save my parents from my vicious wrath.
You don't have a vicious bone in your body.
Quiet, Pater. Me and Nemesios are talking. My sword and shield. Gifts from Mater and Pater. We must return them to my parents, so they can defend themselves from my ferocious temper.
All right, Supidio. I'll get these weapons for you. For a price.
Of course! My parents will gladly pay you for your troubles.
What?!
What?!
Seek out Costa, the village blacksmith. I brought him the sword to be sharpened not too long ago.
And the shield?
This will be trickier. I'll explain when you return from the blacksmith.
Can't wait!
Mistyos, have you changed your mind? Will you bring the sword and shield to my parents? It's the only way to stop the prophecy. You mustn't free me.
Eros on Earth! My name is Costa, at your service.
Alexios.
Whatever you need, name it, it's yours. I could bend some metal for you, oil those rippling muscles, fix that broken spear.
I'm looking for a sword. Belongs to Supidio.
Ah, Supidio. Love that boy. Bit on the thin side, if you ask me. His parents feed him nothing.
Yes. Well, he needs his sword back.
And I'd love to give it to you. His sword, I mean. But I can't just hand over swords to every gorgeous warrior who walks by.
Just give me the sword, or I'll make this a day you'll never forget.
Oh, there's no need to get all heated. Tell you what, I'm drinking wine with someone special tonight. And I'd really like to make a good impression. But there's a small problem. My spear is also broken.
What a shame.
But there are special flowers in the forest beyond the Xerxes military fort. Planted by Aphrodite herself. They really help to, reforge, if you know what I mean.
Fine. I'll get the flowers and you'll give me the spear. I mean, sword. I mean... Don't go anywhere.
Come on.
That should be enough to stoke the blacksmith's flame.
Gorgeous, Miss Theos. You take my breath away. Did you bring the flowers?
Can't even go flower picking without some beast trying to kill me. But, yes, I have them.
Perfect. This will make tonight a night to remember.
I'm very happy for you. Now, what you promised?
Of course, of course. I was just wondering, since we're here, what if I took the flowers now? There's a clean spot in my shop where we could,
I'm only here for the sword. I did what you asked. Now hand it over.
You break my heart, Mistios. But I'll make good use of the flowers. Here's the sword, as I promised.
I should get this back to Stupidio's parents, before he does anything Stupidio.
Mistios, you've returned. Did you bring the sword?
I did.
Thank the gods! I knew I could count on you. But this is only one of the items I needed. And I have two parents.
So tell me about this shield.
Well, according to my parents, it was stolen while I was visiting the Oracle of Delphi.
Stolen? It's as good as gone, then.
I overheard Mater and Pater whispering about it. They mentioned the cave beyond the Red Lake. Talked about the thief as if they knew her.
Strange.
Go to the cave, Mistios. Bring me back my shield. Only then will my parents be truly safe from my fury. Find the cave near the Red Lake. The thief and the sheep should be there.
Time to find this thief.
Pidio mentioned a cave beyond the Red Lake. Strange that his parents knew this. They should get the shield back themselves.